This video is for my friends on the Pond Boss Forum on the internet. I really do appreciate you fellas and all you've done to chip in and give me advice and suggestions and ideas on fish and lake management. Here's the old lake my family has had. My father built this in 1941 or 42. It's older than World War II. And it's about 10 acres that backs up there. I've enlarged it one time. The cabin that you hear me talk about is there. There's a goose nesting raft, and then there's a goose nesting raft way back there in the back. This is my feeding setup. Briefly, I like to keep a chair so I can sit down and work on my feeder, and the timers, set timers and everything. That works the best for me. You'll notice I have the feeder up on blocks. I like to keep it up. I can reach it easier, and it seems to throw it out farther. The garbage can on the left is where I have liked to keep fish food. These are 31-gallon cans. They hold two 50-pound sacks with ease. I'll show you that a little more. In fact, I just go ahead and do that now. I just put two sacks in there, and that's two 50-pound sacks right there with a little bit of room to spare. Now, I do this like with the chain. I've tried a million different ways. I've tried putting wooden tops, blocks, weights, everything. If you do this, and I just used a double snap there, brass snap, and then over here, if you do this and you get it a certain tightness, that's going to stop as well as anything the coons from getting in there, and even sometimes they will still do it. They can probably, if you have it tight enough, if I took it at one more link, they might could get the hand in that one, but you can tighten it up. If you use a rope, if you use a rubber strap, they're going to chew it in two. This is my old spin cast feeder. I'm not advertising American Sport Fish, although they are a mighty good company. I got my fish from them back in the 90s, and these feeders, they no longer handle the feeders. I keep my solar panel on top. These are 12 volt gizmos. The feeder's on top, the solar panel's on top of the feeder. It gets sunlight all throughout the day. If I put it down low, it's easier to deal with, but inevitably the fish feed slings onto it and you have to keep cleaning it off. So I've got this up on stilts. These old feeder legs don't have the capacity to anchor them down to a deck, so we had to just kind of wire them up like that. But this is how it works. And this is one of my feeder docks here at the Old Sides Lake in Coffeyville, Mississippi. Again, I'm doing this for my buddies at Pond Boss. I do appreciate you with all the advice and being the best forum on the internet for people like me and others that like to raise wildlife and manage them and look after lakes and fish and all these outdoorsy things. So thanks again to the guys at Pond Boss.